Look at these people slowly moving through the queue, getting more views onto these adverts, then stand inside of here just to be bombarded by even more adverts. So much money, ladies and gentlemen. This is the greatest airport in the universe.
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Spiffing Brit, and today you join me in the wonderful world of Sim Airport, where we're going to be creating a wonderful airport today. Now, when you sit down and actually think about it, what is the purpose of an airport? If you said it's all about getting a person from point A to point B, then you're wrong. The true purpose of an airport is to milk as much money from any person who has the misfortune of stepping into its boundaries as possible, and to cause so much mental anguish and stress that they would rather collapse on their floor and instantaneously evaporate than continue to live another second inside of this airport. That is what we're going to be creating, as well as also making a gigantic quantity of money along the way. Because hey, I'm British and I love taking other people's money. So without further ado, make sure you're sat back, relaxed, you have a nice warm cup of Yorkshire tea in hand, and if you're feeling especially fantastic, you can even like this video. So without further ado, let's start our brand new airport. Oh, it's going to be beautiful. So this is our lovely airport, ladies and gentlemen. We've loaded in, and this is a very basic airport setup that the game has granted us. It is a single runway, a single terminal, and a place to simply yeet yourself out of a bus and get into this wonderful airport. Oh my goodness, what are these workers? Oh, they are graphically really something. My goodness, the graphics on this game. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Now the thing is, when it comes to items that actually are useful inside your airport, there's a few very important things. You might think a runway so that planes can land, but wrong. The most important feature of any airport is in fact a completely broken and non-working security zone, which also contains a gigantic quantity of these wonderful digital ad displays. A digital ad display is one of the most broken items in this video game, and I'm sure you can probably work out why. This item will annoy people in the local area by showing them an advert. However, it generates revenue based on the amount of people walking past it. You can probably see why this could create a problem, because all you need to do is pack all of your lovely peasants into one area and make sure that they have a continuous stream of advertisements. So we're going to get ourselves some adverts installed, and we will also actually need to set up ourselves a whole bunch of planes. So let's just accept all of these lovely aircraft. We're just going to accept every single aircraft from Lurneyville Air. We're going to have to really shorten down the time that they're actually allowed to, you know, land, because we have to cramp all of these guys in. You see, normally a plane realistically wants about 2 hours to be on the airport, but no. We're just gonna crank it down just a little bit so that they get in and out in 45 minutes. That way we can safely fit all of the aircraft in the day. Some would say that this is dangerous and a complete health and safety violation. To those people, I say probably, but then again, do I care? This way we get more money. So fantastic, we've got all of our aircraft signed in for the day. Now we just need to create a system for all of our lovely customers to arrive. Now remember, airports have some very important features. Feature number one, the airport must be a gigantic maze of death, and that is exactly what we're going to do. We shall create a horrific maze for all of our customers to navigate their way through, and then, and only then, are they going to actually be allowed to go into the security zone. And what's going to be inside of this maze? If you guessed 5,000 hype adverts continuously displaying Raid Shadow Legends, then you'd be correct. Because nothing says I love the airport than 4,000 continuous Raid Shadow Legends plugs. But what happens if you're walking through the airport and your legs start getting a little bit tired because, you know, you've been walking through a maze of death for the last half hour? Well, fear not, ladies and gentlemen, because sandwiched neatly between 7,000 NordVPN sponsorships is a very uncomfortable bench for you and one other person to sit on. And oh my goodness, our first few customers are arriving. This is a fantastic sign. Now, immediately, we actually need to start destroying a few things. We need to sell pretty much all of this, or at the very least dismantle all of our security features, and we want to also fire all of our security guards. Wabam, there we go. It's simple. We don't actually want anyone manning security because we don't want anyone to go through security. Instead, they are for some reason all congregating into this one seating area. And oh, here come the people. Fantastic. Look at all of the foot traffic, all for some reason congregating around the adverts. There's actually a nice bit of space here for us to put adverts, and I've noticed there's also space in all of the bathrooms. That's right, if you want to wash your hands, you're going to have to do it to the tune of 1,000 angry hype men screaming about all of the new characters in Raid. Now, the first aircraft has arrived. This is fantastic. Already, people have departed, and they are just leaving via the corridor of adverts. All of the people waiting in the airport are currently having all of their luggage loaded onto the aircraft. However, there is one issue. The passengers are not being loaded onto the aircraft. Instead, they are throwing around cups and bits of paper and toilet roll that they've found
around in the bathrooms. And now the aircraft has just left without them. 0% of passengers boarded, but I was still paid. Also, the rating has gone up for some reason. This is a fantastic sign. We started with a rating of 50%. We are now up to 56%. This is wonderful. The adverts are being shown. Things are being displayed. This is perfection. Oh, more people are leaving their aircraft. Perfect. But of course, in order to leave and go into the pickup zone, you must first wander through all of the adverts. Oh, this is fantastic. I realized that in this ticketing area, we could also just use more adverts. In fact, why not just create a maze of them? Because people can't walk through them. Yes, it makes perfect sense. They must first walk around the ad displays. Oh, it's my greatest magnum opus. I can't wait to see how much money these advert displays actually make. But currently, ratings are going up even further. 57% positive rating. This is glorious. Workman, get deploying the adverts. You know what you have to do. Now, some people are upset because they missed their flight, and that's okay. We don't care about those people because guess what? When they exit the airport, they still have to walk past the adverts, and it all counts. Can't get these adverts built, you know? We're losing valuable foot passage that we could be charging with these adverts. Now, I did want to actually try to sue an airport for misplacing my luggage, but naturally, it's safe to say I lost the case. God, that one's really bad. I've got another maze of adverts going up there, and honestly, I think as soon as people exit their plane, they should also be put on a gigantic maze of adverts, because otherwise we're just missing valuable customers. Oh, it's fantastic. There we go. You have to get through all of these adverts in order to actually disembark your plane, and then you need to go through all of these adverts in order to actually leave the airport. Meanwhile, ratings are at an all-time high. 58% of people love and are satisfied with the advert airport. So far, no one has even boarded a plane. People have only escaped from planes they already arrived on. Somehow, airport satisfaction 61%. I don't know how. There is rubbish literally everywhere. Environmental rating is at 100%, meaning it is the worst possible because they are just surrounded by continuous screaming adverts and literal garbage smeared all over the walls. It is the worst possible airline, and yet it is 61%. Arguably higher rated than Gatwick. Right, we're going to dismantle one of these displays so that we have access to this brand new terminal. And then because we now have this brand new terminal, we are actually able to summon in new people. What we can now have is a second airline. That's right, we have a brand new gate that we can assign flights to. I suppose the biggest issue for us is that when we hit 7 p.m, we don't really have any flights in the evening, meaning our money kind of dries up. The only issue is, in order to get more than 10 flights per day, we actually need ourselves a gigantic $30,500 worth ATC tower. So we'll just yeet it over here. This will allow us to ram our gates with even more happy passengers. But honestly, first day, really successful. I can't wait to see how much money we made from all of our lovely ads. Oh my goodness, we are fitting in so many flights, it is insane. This is a little bit ridiculous, but it shall work fantastically. Our airport has gone from receiving about 6 flights a day to, I'm pretty sure, well over 20. This is a little bit wild. Anyway, it's coming to the end of the day where we will start receiving all of our advertising revenue. So let's see just how much we made. Oh my goodness, 11 grand in advertising fees. Now that's nice. Ah, perfect. Some of our adverts managed to make $400 each. So over just a couple of days, these bad boys will pay themselves off. But now that we have actually constructed the digital maze of chaos, I think all of our advertising revenues will be increasing very nicely. I suppose there's technically nothing stopping me from actually having security staff, because I suppose that means people will then actually get onto their planes, and ultimately, for the time being, that will give us more money, and that increase in money allows us to buy more advertising stands. All right, well, more digital displays, that's what we're getting, even more of them. And look at this, people going through all of the lovely security areas to stand around here. Fantastic. We do run into an issue here. Honestly, I think people could be given more adverts, so that's exactly what we're going to do. There shall be nowhere that is safe in this seating area. Everyone shall be given an advert. Fantastic, a new plane has arrived and some people have exited. What happens to the people who exit? Well, they're enjoying their time here, and then as soon as they get into this corridor, the environment rating starts going a little bit wild because they're being shown an endless stream of glorious adverts. Isn't it fantastic? Yes, look at them all. You're going to love it. I realize we could probably actually get some more adverts inside of the security area. Why not? It seems like the perfect place for them. Honestly, our rating's going up even more. We're up to 61% rating. This is incredible. Lots of foot traffic going through the airport today, so lots of people seeing these adverts. Lovely stuff indeed. Now, we are starting to get a little bit of a situation where I think people are getting a little bit upset because they're missing their flight because they're not even able to check in. And honestly, that's on them. I don't really want to build more than just 2 ticketing desks. It might lower our passenger rating just a bit, but it's fine. Look, we've shown apparently 6,700 people this advert here. Reasoning is simple. There are hundreds of people here, and every time their eyes glaze onto this digital advert, advert, it detects it and charges them. These digital adverts here are going to make so much money, it is ridiculous. And our airport rating, never been higher, ladies and gentlemen, never been higher. It's just 10 a.m, 11 a.m, ladies and gentlemen, and 9,000 people have seen the advert. We're going to make so much money from this. It is going to be fantastic. Oh my goodness, we've literally created the worst environment here possible. Luckily, we don't really need to do anything about this terrible environment, because the litter on the floor is irrelevant, considering that surrounding everyone is an absolutely million digital display ads. Consequently, they just don't care. People just get in the airport, look at all of the adverts, and then they're off on their merry way. I've done a pretty good job though. I've actually got people to board a plane, which is a decent sign for my company. All of these people miss their flights? Don't care. Doesn't matter. You're frustrated, you hate your environment, you're dying of hunger, and you lack information. Lyra Johnson, that's on you, not me. You decided to come to my airport, okay? Just be happy that you were one of the 12,500 people that got to look at this advert today, okay? It's all about house moving. You're gonna love it. I've created hell. This is literally the worst environment. I mean, people often hate going to the airport for the sole reason that you're going to be surrounded by screaming children. I'd argue that 1,000 endlessly screaming adverts would be even worse. You know, I did have this problem lately where I just couldn't stop telling airport jokes. It's honestly really concerning because my doctor says it's terminal. Literally the worst jokes of the universe. I can't believe it. Oh my goodness, and the advertising fees came through. 52 grand! 52 grand! Oh my goodness. One of these adverts, this advert had been seen by 12,000 people and it has made $1,277. I'm sorry, does that mean that we literally get paid 10 cents per view? That is insane! If I had a video with 12,000 views on and I got $1,200, I'd be a millionaire by now. But my goodness, this is going to be our money-making ways. 52 grand in one day. That's so much more than anything else we've got. Well, it's come to the end of day 4, and I've actually improved the airport. Our rating is now up to 63%, which is fantastic, mostly because I've been dealing with boredom. Now, you might be thinking, how do we entertain people when they're surrounded by adverts? And how can we do so whilst making money? Well, allow me to introduce you to the ATM machine. An ATM machine is a simple item. It makes passengers happy whilst earning us $5 per transaction. Why do ATMs make people happy? I have no bloody idea. But bugger me sideways with a tea bag, is it not the greatest invention known to man? People put in a credit card, it gives me money, and they are happy. It is glorious. On top of all of that, our adverts did very, very well. The ones right in the center of the foot traffic here, we're gaining around about 15,700 per day, meaning we should get around about 1,500 from them. So yep, it has been a good day. We also installed all of these brand new digital ads. Some of them are relatively new, so only got shown to 500 people, which is fine. Yes, this day comes to a close and our money making has actually gone really, really well. We're now starting to make around about 30 grand or so profit every single day. Yes, copious amounts of people are missing their flights, but honestly, no one seems to care. The airlines are still exceedingly satisfied with us, and the passengers are more satisfied than ever. It has honestly been a glorious, fantastical, and financial success. And there we go, we've made 70 grand, ladies and gentlemen. 70 grand. That is insane. The amount of money we make from advertising, ridiculous. It's wonderful. I love it. In total, we made $90,000 yesterday. And look, our first few people have arrived for the day. Already, these adverts are doing great, being seen by 200 people. Oh, it's even more now. Fantastic stuff. Well, the day begins. Right, already the airport is in full swing, ladies and gentlemen. It's 7 a.m, which means we've got flights coming at us from all directions. These adverts have been seen by thousands and thousands of people already. Already, people have gotten so bored, they're starting to put their credit cards into the ATMs. Splendid stuff. Look at this man, Cameron Baldito. He was so bored and so in need of entertainment, he decided to use the ATM machine. It just works. It's fantastic. It's like, what should I do whilst I'm waiting for a plane? Should I sit down in the litter-filled seat surrounded by adverts, or should I go to the ATM machine and spend $5? Oh, it's brilliant. Well, I think we just increase speed even more and see what happens at the end of the day, because things are going fantastically for us so far. I think we can just expand this operation more and more and more and more and just see what eventually happens, because more flights mean more passengers, and more passengers means more customers. In fact, you know, we could probably turn this into a 24/7 operation. So what's stopping us from taking flights in the evening? Oh, we need to upgrade our runway so that it has lights. Okay, well, that seems like a fine investment. Right, bam. Upgrade with lights. It only costs 25 grand. Fantastic. Bam, it's on. Now we can finally start annoying customers all day, every day. Oh yes, with morning and evening flights, the airport will never end. These people miss their flights. What are they doing? They're just gonna remain sat on the seats looking at the adverts. Fantastic. Right, well, we can finally start accepting PM flights. So that's exactly what we're going to do. Aero Times, we'll take that flight. We'll take this flight, take these two flights as well, and also this one. Fantastic. This is splendid stuff indeed. Right, now let us start packing them all in. Now what about flights in the morning? Well, there's not many of them, but let's do it. Right, now people will start arriving at the airport from before 3 a.m. to start squeezing their way onto these flights, so this is fantastic. We are now properly booked in with all of these flights. The airport will never sleep now. So much foot traffic, so many advertisements, so much money. I wonder if we could actually put the pickup area indoors. Oh, this is fantastic. I can put people inside the pickup box and they have to wait for their bus to arrive, and then we can fill the pickup box with adverts. Oh, this is it. This is wonderful. Yes, adverts everywhere. We'll give them a few seats as well to sit down on so they can properly enjoy these adverts. Oh, this is it. Look at that wonderful stuff. Now we can monetize everyone, even when they leave, when they're angry. Now, we do actually have to be kind of careful when we place down all of these brand new doors, because it is as the wise old man once said, "He who walks through the airport door sideways is going to Bangkok." Okay, that is S-tier dad joke. It doesn't get better than that. I guarantee you there is no better airport joke than that one. All right, now as day 5 comes to an end, we prep ourselves for the wonderful day 6. Day 6 is when the airport is going to be going non-stop from start to finish. Continuous foot traffic going through. It is going to be wild. Who knows how much money we're going to make? Who knows how well the adverts will even do? There's only one way to find out. All right, we're coming to the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen. How much money are we going to make? Here it comes. $59,000. Perfect stuff. Lovely, 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 lovely. Airport rating 67%. It's never been better. Right, now the new day begins with more customers than ever before and more rubbish than ever before. Oh my goodness, it's 12 a.m. and people are already here waiting for their flight. They're just here that early. They are so proactive. This is already fantastic. It's coming up to 3 a.m. and already hundreds of people, if not thousands, have started seeing these adverts. This is fantastic stuff. Oh, this is really going well. 4 a.m. and look at the amount of people now flooding in. Thousands of people waiting to purchase their tickets. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is what peak airport efficiency looks like. We only have one tiny runway and two terminals, but we are able to make thousands. 71% customer satisfaction rate. Look at that. I don't know how. How could you be satisfied in this horrific, nightmarish environment where you're having to hug up against a bajillion other fleshy humans with adverts continuously blaring and your only source of happiness being an ATM machine? It makes no sense. It really doesn't, but the money just keeps flowing and that's all I care about. It's actually really good to see that security's taking a long while, because when security takes a while, that means we can start making money. Although actually, we could make ourselves a queue. If we start a queue all the way down here, there we go, and we'll assign it to here, we can actually have people start queuing up for security. And what this means is they'll actually start seeing more and more of these adverts. It's 9 a.m. and these adverts have been viewed over 11,000 times. This is it. This means they've already made more money than they made in the entirety of yesterday, and we're not even halfway through the day. Oh, it's fantastic. And I can hear the continuous printing of the ATM machines as well. The only source of happiness in a capitalist environment. The ATM machine. Oh, it's so good. It is so good. Now, what else are people upset about? Some people are upset about the lack of information. Now, we can actually do something about that. We could probably also do something about the lack of food. Maybe if I search for snack, there we go, food vending machine. This will satisfy people's desire for hunger, of course, at the cost of money, and that will actually kill two birds with one stone. There we go, people are already actually using it. Fantastic. Because when you get hungry, because you've been standing in the pile of adverts and rubbish for the last 4 hours, you can go over here and satiate your hunger, and then suddenly you'll actually be okay with waiting in this horrific pile of adverts. Oh my goodness, the food vending machines and the ATM machines are doing fantastic. People go to the ATM machine to take out money to go to the vending machine. It's perfect. The cycle of the economy. Oh my goodness, look at the mass of people waiting at security to go the other way. This is fantastic. Every single individual bag has to be scanned, and everyone must also be scanned whilst looking at adverts. It is glorious. Ah, so much money can be made. So much glorious money. Aircrafts going in continuously. In fact, it looks like we can even accept even more aircraft, so that's exactly what we'll do. Get two more early morning aircraft. This is entirely because airlines are now really starting to enjoy working with us. Airline satisfaction, it's high. Right, we've now rammed the schedule with as many aircraft as we feasibly can. All of these planes in the middle of the day, most of them don't even arrive at the airport because there's technically not even enough time for them. Which is fine, because effectively this plane is set to depart 5 minutes before this one arrives, and if it doesn't depart in that time, this airplane just doesn't land. It's incredible. Anyway, we've booked all of those lovely planes in, and our advertising revenue is due for the day, and it would seem that we successfully made 100,000 in advertising revenue yesterday, which is wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. 100 grand just in adverts. Right, and now the airport has opened opened up. We've got people waiting in line for security and being bombarded by adverts whilst they do so. This ad display made almost $3,000 yesterday. Oh my goodness, this is wild. It's 2 a.m. and already the food vending machine has made $200. This food vending machine is probably making us thousands every single day. And now come in the big planes with the big advert halls. This is incredible. Look at these people slowly moving through the queue, getting more views onto these adverts, then stand inside of here just to be bombarded by even more adverts. So much money, ladies and gentlemen. This is the greatest airport in the universe. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This is how to run an airport. If you've enjoyed, make sure to like the video. Remember, 72% of people enjoyed this airport, so you are legally required to go into the comment section and say exactly that the Spiffco airport is greater than Heathrow itself. That way, when people Google search the greatest airport, they get this, the trap maze of adverts and death, where you have to pay your entire life savings to sustain yourself on vending machine food, or you just simply collapse and die whilst waiting to even purchase a ticket for your own aircraft, all whilst being bombarded by Raid Shadow Legends. It's fantastic. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I've been the Spiffing Brit. If you've enjoyed watching today's video, then make sure to give it a like and do consider subscribing. As always, a massive thank you to each and every one of our amazing patrons who make these fantastic videos all the more possible. Seriously, pat yourselves on the back, you lovely, majestic sausages. And if you sat there wondering what video you'd like to watch next, look no further than this one on screen now, handpicked by me to be absolutely perfect for you. Anyway, I'll see each and every one of you in the next one. Have an absolutely lovely day and goodbye for now.